Welcome back, friend. I'm Heather. Thanks for joining me. We're talking all about meal planning strategies for families. And I'm a mom of four. I've got strategies, I got tips, and I am excited to share with you. So last week, we talked about how to easily add more variety into your meals. So if you missed that video, definitely go back and listen because it's a very simple strategy that doesn't make you have to rethink all your meals, but how to just add little tweaks and make them a little different, get out of that food rut, get into more variety. But today we're gonna be talking about strategies for saving time in the kitchen. Because if you are making home cooked meals, that can take a lot of time. So how can we save time in the kitchen, get healthy meals to our family in less time? Let's talk about it. This is gonna be so fun. So my first tip for how to save time in the kitchen is to think about meal prep. And there are so many different ways that you can do this. And I'm gonna share first the strategy that I use, but then I'm also gonna share a few different strategies that you can think about because everybody's different, everybody's got their own unique situation, and the way that works for me might not work for you, but there's other ones that you can consider to see if they can be helpful for you. So the strategy that I most often use is to just get a little bit ahead when I'm already in the kitchen. So what does that look like? Okay, so if I am making dinner, I'm thinking in my mind, what are we having tomorrow? What can I do to get a little bit ahead? Can I prep some overnight oats for the next morning or prep a pancake batter so that I don't have to do all the mixing or the measuring in the morning? What can I do right now to get a little bit ahead? So the strategy of really thinking about your future self. How can I help future Heather in my current present moment? So I use that strategy for so many things in my life, but it is really helpful for when I'm thinking about how can I help myself save time in the kitchen, because if I've got my cutting board out, I'm already chopping potatoes for dinner, can I chop kale for the next morning or whatever might be on the menu for tomorrow's dinner? So I'm just getting a little bit ahead, especially if I already have tools out that I can use and not have to get them out tomorrow, because one, that means less dishes, but two, it just means I'm just being more efficient with my time. So another strategy that people love or hate, you can love it, you can hate it, is to prep meals in advance. So that could be taking a couple hours on a free day, maybe on the weekend, and thinking about prepping two or three dinners in advance, or two or three breakfasts, or whatever you need help with. Prep them fully instead of components so that they are done and ready. And when it comes to dinner time, all you have to do is pull it out of the fridge, warm it up however you need to, and then dinner is ready. And that can be really helpful because you're in the kitchen for a bulk of time. Maybe you're there for 2 hours, but it saves you future time. So you can do all the chopping. Like I said, your cutting board's out, your knife is out, maybe your food processor is out, your oven is on. You're doing all of these things instead of doing them three times in the week. You're doing one big long stretch. Okay, so another strategy that is so smart is to double what you're already making and then freeze the extra for another day. So what that can look like is maybe it's taco night and you know next week you're gonna have the same tacos. You're making taco meat. Make a double batch of the taco meat, cool it, or cool half of it, freeze it, and then next week you don't have to cook it again. All you have to do is pull it out of the freezer, defrost it, and that step is done for you. Make sure that you're labeling and dating in case it gets, you know, stuck under some peas and some strawberries in your freezer so that you're not forgetting about it and it gets wasted, but that can be a really helpful strategy. Okay, and another last tip that I wanted to share is to use your kitchen tools wisely. So my food processor, oh my goodness, it's one of my favorite kitchen tools because it can chop for me, it can blend things up, it can shred, it can turn oats into oat flour, it can do so much. So if you have tons of chopping to do and all you need is a dice, try out a food processor. Or maybe a slow cooker or an Instant Pot can really help you to save time. Instead of watching some meat in the oven, it can just sit on the counter and do its thing and you're not having to think about it. And another tool that I absolutely love, and it's so small, but it's just, is so helpful is a garlic press. And it's just this little tool, I wish I had it with me right now, where I put a garlic clove in, I don't have to peel it, and I squeeze it, and the garlic comes out. So just kitchen tools, use them when you've got them. If you need to add more in and you have that ability, think about what would be really helpful. Where is a hang up where something can be helpful for you? So I hope that you found these tips helpful. Leave a comment down below. Let me know if you have a strategy for saving time in the kitchen, what works for you, maybe what you're thinking about trying. And be sure to subscribe to Fit Mama Real Food, because next week I'm gonna be sharing how to customize a meal plan. If you don't want a meal plan and you just want somebody to do it, but it's not exactly what you're looking for, I have some simple strategies that you can use to make that meal plan perfect for you and your family. And it's honestly just takes a little tweaking, and I'm so excited to share those tips with you. So be sure to subscribe. I can't wait to have you back here again, and I'll see you later. Bye.